Mori.
You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. The legend, the curses, foolishness about it lying in the middle of the City of the Dead, buried beneath a blood-red cloud. A bright, shining monument luring treasure hunters to their doom. The world's most famous stars and entertainers were invited to its grand opening. An invitation was a sign of exclusiveness. The opening was supposed to symbolize a road to a brighter future, not just for the world, but for all who came to its doors. A chance for anyone to begin again. Except, the Sierra Madre never opened. The war froze it in time, like a big flashbulb going off. The grand opening. One big ending of humanity. It's still out there, in the wastes, preserved, just waiting for someone to crack it open. But getting to it, that's not the hard part. It's letting go.
Are you listening? Good. From now on, when I talk, listen and follow my instructions. Play stupid. Play clever. Make the mistake of saying no. That collar on your neck will go off and take your head with it. It's like that pit boy on your wrist. Except filled with explosives. A little radio of the old world. Just needed some tune. Do what I say, and the collar won't go off. Refuse, try and run, disobey me, I'll kill you and find someone else. There's no escape from here until I let you go. The sooner you accept your situation, the better. That structure you see above the fountain, the Sierra Madre Casino, you need to break inside. Heist. Too many years in the making. But to get inside, avoid its traps, you'll need to gather a team. As I found, one cannot do it alone. Around the villa are three other collars like yours. Collar 8, 12, and 14. Find all three and get them here to the fountain. Then we'll talk more. And should you get any ideas about killing each other and taking the treasure of the Sierra Madre for yourself, a warning. All your collars are linked. One of you dies, you all die. If that's what it takes to make you cooperate, so be it. I've downloaded the instructions and markers on your Pip-Boy, in case you forget. And yes, I have access to that device on your wrist. Get the other three here after that. I'll have more instructions for you. Do this, I'll let you go. I'll let all of you go. Good. If necessary, I will guide you through the villa's broadcast systems. If you get lost, return here, and I'll direct you. I've downloaded instructions on an audio log to your Pip-Boy in case you can't read. If you forget why you're here, let my voice remind you.
Come to a place where wealth, excitement,
bomb caller. frequency and can trigger the detonators prematurely. It is an unfortunate side effect, one I did not anticipate. I was unable to calibrate the collars to block the signals. So, you'll have to make do.
Noise makes my stomach hurt.
Knew you would come below the cage, down to where I am. Maybe you saw the letters I scratched on the villa walls. A little farther. Follow my voice. That's it. The one in the cage? Dog. I had to... That's me, there on the table. The disc. My voice. Can't take any chances, though. You may be some victim who simply stumbled down here. If so, can't let you let Dog out. No, not yet. If you're who I think you are, you came to fetch Dog. Use him to drag others here. Now I'll use you and that Pip-Boy you're wearing. You're smart, clever. The key to Dog's cage is simple. Take my voice to the cage above. Let me speak to the beast inside. Then you and I, we can talk.
Dog, back in the cage. Dog, back in the cage.
What have we here? You weren't who I was expecting. I'm disappointed. Still, even if you aren't my intended guest, you take direction. Good. You can't have been an idiot to figure out how to release me from my cage. Or perhaps you are, with that leash on your arm and the one around your neck. With our collars and manacles, why, we may as well be kin. The carving's a reminder for mirrors and for Dog. Dog, who you heard coming in, howling and hungry, as always. I've been trapped in here for some time. Then you come along and let me out. So, you opened my cage for a reason. Now, I want to know why. Trauma. Yes, in a manner of speaking. Do you see these wounds of his covering his skin? The bear trap on his arm. He placed his own hand in it. The name he carved in his chest. To remind him of who he is, he inflicts pain on himself to silence me. When all I try to do... he cuts... hurts and tries to murder me out of him. He won't succeed. Just makes me angrier. Dog is the beast. We simply change cages. Like the ones here. It's close. Closer than I'd like. Dog's been into things. Needs to think before he eats. Chew before he swallows. He's eager that way. Now the collar's a part of me. Inside. I can feel its electronic heartbeat clicking and burning down below. Like before. It was cold and heavy before going in the cage. Now you're here and it's pulling and kicking again. Tugging like a leash. Interesting. As if I had a choice. Sometimes instinct takes over, and that's when I go into the cage. It's like curiosity that way. After all, You wouldn't have put that collar on by choice. Perhaps it was your curiosity that caused that hand to close on your neck. Really? Yet it led you here, to me. And now you're here, and it's burning a hole in my guts. Maybe it's crying for its owner. No. No, I don't think so. Even in here, I have more control than you do. I'm not leaving until the one who controls the collars shows. Not his voice, not his hand, not his lackey. Him. And when he comes to see me, we'll settle things. So go on. Go back to your master. Tell him I'm waiting for him. Dog may follow him. I won't. Then I still win. I'd rather die in this cell than have Dog follow him any longer. Follow his orders, his commands, desperate for recognition. The old man, he has the need to hold on to the past, to the Madre. I'd rather be free, let go of this shell, than have it cage me any longer. No, I don't trust you. Even if you're not working with him, you'll fall into the same trap he did. You may think you can take your revenge. That'll change. You'll start thinking there's a way to have it all. They all wanted their freedom at first. Then, they realized they could get inside the Sierra Madre. After that, their freedom wasn't important anymore. They couldn't let go. Just like the old man. So you say you want your freedom. No. Even if you feel that way, it won't last. You'll forget, get greed blind, and you'll turn. Dog? You're not talking to him now, are you? No. Even if you could drag Dog out of his cage, you still couldn't get him out of this cage. I put him here for a reason. If he could have escaped, he would have. So here he stays. Of course you can't. This cage is locked tight. From you and the old man. Of course I know. Even if I don't see it happen. Down in the cage, I hear echoes of the footfalls, the click of the collars. Every time I see one of you, I know exactly how you got here. You couldn't help yourselves any more than Dog can help himself. You heard the voice, the promise. And then you walked right into one of the old man's traps. Then Dog comes for you, drags you here. You're not him any more than I'm Dog. But that collar around your neck, you're an extension of the old man's grasp. Clumsy, perhaps, but a tool, yes. And once you get acclimated to the Sierra Madre, then you'll feel the same overpowering hunger the old man does. And then you'll be him, not just his hand. Elijah. Human. Weak like all of you are. Feeling age circling him like starved dogs, howling for blood. To me, he reeks of age and failure. And madness. To me, he is simply the old man. To Dog, he is Master. His name, meaningless. Running out of years, hopes and dreams running through his withered hands like sand from the big empty, and scorched by the sun. Of course I know. Even if I don't see it happen, down in the cage, every time I... Me? You think I want to haul bodies around the wastes like a Brahmin at the whip? No. Dog does it. When the old man says fetch, Dog fetches. You were in a man trap, and Dog made his rounds and dragged you here. When, I don't know. But it must have been recent, before the cage. I don't remember you. That isn't surprising. What is that it was when Dog was out of his cage. Free, hungry. He knows not to eat anything he catches in the traps. After that, however, so he dragged you here. You got spared. Dog must have fed after you arrived. Once he was fed, that allowed me out of the cage and put him inside. Do you remember how long you were out? Must have already been in the cage. Already had the collar in me. You're lucky Dog didn't devour you. Otherwise, we'd be closer than we are now. Of course. The key? Why, it's the old man, the one who brought us here. I hid the key on me so Dog wouldn't know. I just need the old man to show up so he and I can talk. If Dog was in control when the old man appeared, well, he would just do whatever he commanded, as always. And I can't have that. Dog obeys, yes. Why? Do you have some means of contacting the old man? You... don't play it. If you do, I'll find a way to get out of the cage, end you. I'll murder you, crush your arms and legs until... No, you wouldn't. If you did, you won't escape this place alive. I'd shatter every one of your limbs to splinters and leave you here. You think I'm afraid of your collar exploding, killing us? No. I'll leave you breathing, then keep walking until my collar goes cold. I'll prop your broken body in view of the Sierra Madre so you can see what you came to steal. Forever out of reach as you die. Prove it. How? Words are worthless. No. No, you're not. Even though Dog's more docile, easier to control, you may regret this. This place is where creatures like Dog can survive. The people that fill its streets. He is as vicious, more vicious than them. His hunger can help you more than I can. When I am in control, this shell is difficult to fight in. I am not sure you belong here. No, you don't belong here. Yet, you came this far, and I'm not interested in remaining here any longer. I'll unlock the cage. Very well. To the fountain and its ghost, then.
Should never have...
Have a seat, and then we'll talk. The Sierra Madre. Beauty, isn't she? She the one who invited you here? Or maybe you didn't catch her voice on the radio. Woke up confused like some of the others. Least you're still breathing. By the way, don't get up or make any sudden motions, no matter how uncomfortable that chair gets. The cushion's just for show. Sounds like you've done some blue-collar construction work in your life. Your ma must be proud. Still, get up without my permission. I'll blast your ass so far through your head, it'll turn the moon cherry pie red. So, let's keep this sweet and polite and finish our conversation with no misunderstanding. And that's what I've missed, a rapt audience. Just because I work in entertainment doesn't mean I'm a moron. I heard my necktie beeping. I know what that means. I'm part of this somehow. I want out of this contract. And if you put me in it, I'm not going to be too happy. So whatever's going on here, if you're part of all this, you're taking orders from me. What are you talking about? That's an interesting clause. That's a real bad contract you have. We have. All right. Looks like marriage finally caught me. I'm listening, partner. What's next if we're death till we part? Not leaving me much choice. The fountain, huh? Hope the hologram's still working and the battery's running strong. I'll follow you. I'm not going alone, trust me. Not like I'm a coward or anything. I'm not running around town without an escort. I'm serious. One of the locals catches us. We aren't coming back. And I'd like to keep an eye on you. Wait. Wait just a minute. I'm not walking out there on my own. I know what's out there. It's why I've planted a minefield, shotguns and explosives all the way on the road to my little boudoir here. So we go together or we're not going at all. I'll split my hand in blackjack when the time's right. I'm not splitting up in this town, trust me. That's a good point. All right. Let me grab some smokes, and I'll meet you at the fountain. Don't have to take the long way back. There's a shortcut across the way, you see? It's through the cloud, but if I'm with you, I can help you through it. If you didn't already force the lock to the gate, that is.
I'm here. You could have just left, but you're too obsessed to let go.
I used to know a ventriloquist with more skill than you. At least he had the sense to know his own name without calling it in his chest.
Mirrors tell me my name when needed, and I have a name for you. You, several. Coward.
done. Now for the festivities and your part in all this. The owner of the Sierra Madre, for whatever reason, keyed the grand opening to the gala event itself. It needs to be fired off in order for the casino doors to open. As I've discovered, one person can't do it. So get your team into position indicated on your Pip-Boy, then trigger it properly. You're so close now, don't let me down. Otherwise, I'll have to rely on the next team. I'd suggest taking the FEV reject to his position first. Although you may need his brutality and strength elsewhere first. As easy as the villa was to navigate, the outlying areas of the villa are far more dangerous, thicker with the ghost people, traps, and toxins. Use your team as I use you. Listen to your caller. Watch where you step. You're no use to me dead.
So, are we on our way to somewhere else? A gala event, perhaps? Maybe Dog will obey you. I'm not as easily broken. If it isn't the... So here we are, a row of switches all lined up. How familiar. These switches won't move themselves, after all. There must be some trick to it. Now that I'm here, what do you expect me to do? You can lead me to water. No. Being trapped in this courtyard while lights are flashing and sirens are screaming, I can survive one or two of the inhabitants. More than that, even Dog would have to work to keep full without being carved to pieces. And the gate here, if it somehow got locked, it'd be the holding cell at the police station again.
except with no way out. Really? And why is that? Dog is much more docile, obedient. You're right, but trust? Trust is such a harsh word. I prefer mutual need. It's more honest. No, I can help you. These wiring diagrams. I know how to operate the switches in sequence to make fire appear in the sky. We just need to make sure that Dog doesn't surface before that happens. To do that, he'll need to be fed. That makes him stay in the cage. Dog has torn apart a number of the inhabitants of this town. Well, he doesn't prefer them to other flesh. It'll do for the time being. Find some of the inhabitants. It'll require some hunting on your part. Kill them. Take some of the remains inside them. Bring it back here. They're not easy to kill. But I have faith in you, and the beast must be fed if you want him to stay in this cage. Two chunks of meat from their bodies should be enough. Hunt quietly, so as not to draw more here. You better have brought enough meat. I can feel Dog's teeth tearing at my ribs, hungry to get out. You're good at fetching. This should keep him where he belongs. For now. I'll wait. Send the signal. We'll be ready.
poke him with a stick or something.
Scalar area. Now make him stay.
Look. I strike up the speaker system. There's going to be ghosts all over this place. Any change in the sounds around here? The ghost people are not big on talking. They are big on listening. Hunting. Killing. More vicious than music critics, trust me. No, you want to know why? Well, yeah. If the hologram system still worked, that'd do the trick. Okay, all right. You call up some of those old world stiffs. That'd be an audience I wouldn't mind having below. If I remember correctly, there should be two holograms you can switch. Now, if it is... You powered the holograms up. Well, yeah, that's pretty good protection. But, how do I know the power? Well, yeah. Oh, but listen, when this thing goes off, try and get into the Sierra Madre without me. You'll wish you hadn't.
the bell tower. That's where you'll trigger the gale event. It's a ways up. I'm sure you'll find a way to climb up there. To the speaker in the tower, then. There.
Ready. The both of us. I'll keep Dog locked in his cage. You just open the Sierra Madre.
What are you waiting for, Republican? Strike up the band already. Careful what you do.
Think the villas are there now.
You haven't seen anything yet.
Finally! Now, the gates will open, and so will the skies.
Thank you. recordings. Dead echoes in the frequencies. Casino Security is shutting down, opening up its vendor and gambling programs in the back casino. Still might be something for sale. Maybe something can help you now security's shut down. After you're done looking around, head to the lobby and we'll deal with you, friends. Casino's woken up, paying attention to us. Good.
Going to make Casino
hurry up
burn.
And deal with the FEV
no
agent.
More,
he's
please.
Of no use to us.
Going to make Casino.
That idiot's opened the gas valves. A single spark, or he sets off his collar. The casino's
wants...
going to burn.
You? Master? No, not Master. Dog remembers you. Left dog in cage. Mean to dog. Now, dog.
Will kill us both unless you do something. Never felt him so strong before. He won't listen to my voice. He's...
hungry. Come here, or dog will chase you, break you until you no run anymore. Hmm? Master? Don't want Master to be mad. What does Master want dog to...
Listen to you. Can't hold him back much longer. Tell him to pull on his chain as hard as...
Dog can. What Master wants, dog can do. Please don't be mad with dog. Master? Master? Dog? Dog is listening.
Both of us are. Tell him to listen to me. Then we can get out of this. Finally. And...
Now dog is listening to voice. Your voice only. Dog can see the voice. Looks just like dog.
And dog looks just like me. You've hurt yourself. Inside. Do you see now? See?
In the water. Dog understands now. Dog knows what happened. If dog goes into the water, dog can't help if Master gets mad. You were nice to dog. Dog wants to help.
He's right. If you merge us, then we, or whatever we become, we can't help you when you reach whatever's at the Sierra Madre's end.
And dog... Dog doesn't want to unremember you, may forget you.
We will forget almost all that has happened here. You'll be alone, at the old man's mercy. Like Dog. Like me.
You were there all the time.
All the time. You were there. And so close. Together. Who are you? What is this place? That was not the answer I was expecting. I don't know you. Yet I feel like I do. And a feeling of gratitude. Forgive me, I'm wounded. This chain, this bear trap on my arm. How did I even get this far with these wounds? The pain is excruciating. I need to rest for a moment. thank you for whatever you have done. I will remain here. Need to get my strength back.
Us, along with you. Shut off the gas valve so that idiot will kill us all.
You showed. Felt the collar start kicking again as soon as the elevator doors rattled open. Think you're going to upstage me here at the Sierra Madre? I don't think so. Now that I'm inside, well, I don't need you anymore. Me? I was halfway off the rooftop, through the service tunnel, and beelining for the gate before the light show started. And before Vera finished her gala speech. I knew what had happened with music in the streets and lights in the sky. Ghost people. Lots of them. But that was your problem. Anyway, front gate was open, no way I was letting you get in first. I walk in. There's a flash, and I'm here. Must have been Sinclair's security. He always had a thing about letting any threats into the casino. Security system's twitchy that way. Me, though, I'm a guest here, so I guess I got the royal treatment after all. You think I'm the bad guy here? I'm not the one slapping bomb collars on innocent folks and flicking the switch. And I'm not stabbing you in the back. I was facing you all the time. This heist, I planned it lifetimes ago. You and that old man, tourists. Time for a little show. I'll just grab a seat and watch how this plays out from backstage. Security can handle it from here. No, no. The collars. I know what happened now. Sure, mine activated, but it feels different, the electronic tap dance inside. I can kill you and still make it out while security is busy frying you to a crisp. Hands are clean, then smooth sailing to the Sierra Madre. Way I figure it, you'll try and run for the exit. And only I know where the key is. And where the safest place in the whole theater is. Backstage. You're trapped down there. And you couldn't shut off the speakers, unlock the doors, or cancel security if you tried. What? What now? Try and come back here? No, you belong out in the audience. I mean, not like, you could get backstage. That key you snagged, it won't work. Of all the... Where the hell are those stupid holograms already? Even if you get back here, you won't live long, trust me. All right, you're resourceful, I'll give you that. It's going to take a lot more than juggling keys and shooting speakers to stop me. As I see it, all I need to do is kill you, then make a run for the exit. You do the same, you'll be clawing at the lock until your head blows off. So, maybe you and I should have a little chat, just like we did when you first waltzed into town. Lucky guess. You sure about that? Because if you make a mistake, well, Sierra Madre's got us both. All right, look. I'll hand it over, I promise. No need to get all upset. We can both come out ahead in this. Look, I give you this key, and there's nothing to keep you from just killing me and running. And as I see it, I just gave up my ace in the hole. So the only chance I've got left is making sure you don't leave. And there's no way in hell I'm letting you get to the Sierra Madre vault instead of me. Not after all this time. I waited an entire lifetime, sitting in that villa, watching it all fall apart. Sinclair's Sierra Madre towering over everything, untouched. Then you show up, thinking you can just take it all from me, you and the old man running the show. I planned all this. I made it all happen, not you. Sure, yeah, I have the key on me. I made other keys, too, to unlock the casino and ruin Sinclair, finally. After all these years. No. Now I think ruining you and all your plans would be enough for me. Kill me, I still win. You're never getting in the vault.
Going to need a hand here, partner.
What I need from the music archives. Once you have the last fragment, you can thread the archives together at the main floor terminal.
It sealed. All doors are locked down. Security's activated. And emitter signals are lighting up all over this floor.
We all pay
I'll do
for
what
we've
I can
done.
From here. The door's
I'm
got
so
holographic
sorry.
Security.
Sinclair.
Not latest tech. Field of view targeting systems. Primitive.
I'm so far to be here.
Familiar.
No. I just want to leave. Sinclair, where did you go? Why did you leave me here? Why?
You made it. Good. There's to talk. I'll keep this quick in case my voice goes out. Do I? Sounds off to my ears. Hard to tell. Not to mention it hurts like hell to swallow. Might be why I got moved off to this suite. It's hers. That's her over there. Got trapped by security like I did. Just took a different way out. I've been hunting the one who hijacked your Pip-Boy, Elijah, for some time. He cannot leave the Sierra Madre alive. What he's done? What he's done here is nothing compared to what he's done in the past. The only way to bring him out is if you get to the vault. He won't allow you to go down there alone. That's when we kill him. Too long. Thought I might have had a chance to settle it before this event happened. But then the chance slipped away again. Those are my orders. I've seen what he's done, and I believe in those orders. He cut me off from someone I cared about a long time ago. He used his status to break us apart. So I had to find a new purpose. Same banner. Then he became unstable. Left a trail of crimes across the wasteland. Once word reached us, I was ordered to kill him. He saw me, before the scars, at a place far from here. It's where he found some of the technology he uses now. It's a place called the Big Empty. The name's deceptive, if you know where to look. Almost got trapped there. There was someone else, though, who came along. Knew about Elijah. No idea. A courier. Wore an old-world flag on his back. He was the one who pulled me out there. Told me where Elijah had gone. Helped me heal up. Listened to my story. He sympathized. He said he understood what it meant to track someone who had such a impact on his past life. He said people were like couriers, sometimes never understanding the messages they brought. That's who he was hunting for. Some courier. Wasn't sure until now I could trust you. Now I know. Look, when I woke up here, however that happened, I had this key on me. I think it belongs to her. Haven't had a chance to use it yet. Might open the dresser or the safe. Didn't have time to experiment with it before you arrived. Here you go. The gala went off. The switching station opened up. Thought the screeching in the auto dock was bad. Station worse. Got outside, saw the light show, and it was enough to make me run to the casino. Also, it seemed like the lights and speakers were helping to guide me. Guess your master wanted a backup in case you died. As for being assigned to this floor, maybe it's because of my new voice. Your guess is as good as mine. Maybe it recognized me as a guest. Yeah, still functional. A lot of garbage data on it. Its basic procedures should still work fine. I can see. Check the route. Recent diagnostics. A lot of Med-X was dispensed for Vera Keys. Guess that's her corpse there for certain. And why all those meds are scattered around in here. Here's the medical report. Looks like she had some sort of terminal condition. Diagnosis isn't conclusive. Must have been painful. I'm not even sure she knew if these medical reports are enough. She must have been numb most of the time. Good luck. He's not an easy opponent. If I can, I'll help. Might be able to figure something out using the Sierra Madre's computer systems. Quick scribe. Jumped over the lazy power.
The elevator to the casino. Vault is locked. Find a way to open it.
Christine Royce of the Brotherhood.
That's all I need. Now, go to the main lobby terminal, thread the music sequence together.
Thank you.
You're back. You sure you still... You did. Looks like even the old world can't keep you out when you've got a mind to get in. So, I just rasp out some words and the vault opens? That woman, the Starlet, she didn't build this place. Why would the Builder do that? I know. The sealed doors, the security, it's almost a fortress. Think that's why we're being ordered to come here and crack it open? Love makes people do strange things. Won't argue that. It can drive you crazy sometimes if you can't connect. If they loved each other, and they were together, I suppose that's all that mattered. But she's in that side room, dead, because the casino wouldn't let her leave. Who knows where he is? All right. If you go down there, are you prepared? What if you don't come back? I just wanted to make sure you're ready. When you go down there, that may be it for us. We won't be needed anymore. The one who made these collars, he'll follow you down there. And he won't let you leave. He's not one for sharing. Never was. I can't let him leave here. Look, you've done so much, and he's not gonna show himself until you go down there. I can't let go. Every time I've thought about it, I've lost him so many times. He needs to die. What happened here with us? He's done so much worse. You have to promise me. Promise me you'll deal with him. If I see him, I... All right, I'll... But I'll need to leave this floor. He'll pick up my collar and... Never mind. Let me get the vault open. Begin again. But know when to let go. Sounds like you.
The floor looks like it protected the guests too well. Check the suite. Found the holographic woman from the Villa Fountain.
Begin again, but know when to let go. I wish you luck in the vault. Elijah, he's tough to pin down.
into the vault and don't touch anything else. There may be more traps down there. Another security system. Hiding? You speak as if your fingers have never touched the keys of a Robco turret. The Pip-Boy's operating system has vulnerability. No. I'm not going to take the chance while I'm so close. Not this close. No. Not again. I can wait. Afford to be careful. You? You're locked down there. This is the only entrance. And I have free reign of the Sierra Madre. I have time. More than you. Besides, there might be more traps. I'll send more scouts in. Yes, others. You're resourceful. Don't want to leave anything more to chance. No, I don't think so. It'd most likely trigger other security measures, if you hurt the vault at all. The builder of the casino built it to last. The Sierra Madre withstood the war. I'm sure the vault is protected as well. Besides, you wouldn't have followed the signal if you didn't want this place's secrets for your own. You're curious, past the threats. You might destroy access to the data, not the data itself. Besides, there would be safeguards in place. But you recognize the value of what's down there. You would no sooner destroy what's inside the Sierra Madre than destroy yourself. Persist in threatening me or the Sierra Madre's secrets. You're of no use to me. I'll set off your collar now. Huh. Clever.
Whoever designed the Sierra Madre, their obsession with messing with frequencies and signals. I'm coming down. I'll meet you face to face at the vault entrance. If you resist, I'll use the collar even if it puts the vault at risk.
What's this? Alarms. What? You think you can run? This entire structure is mine to command. Security, weapons, all. You think you've outsmarted me? You can't get away. You're the one on a leash. You always were. You've heard stories of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. This story's different than the others. It's all in promise of beginnings and the ending.
Dog forgot himself, as did the voice that raged within him. After their passing, a new voice spoke within the mutant shell. It was difficult for the voice to remember the two it once was. There was the beast, Dog, consumed by hunger. And the other, in reverse, the one consumed by control. Both were driven by need for the other. The courier brought them together somehow, joined the two into one. All that happened at the Sierra Madre was a faint memory to the new personality, like a flickering light in the clouds of the mind. The new voice did not think of the courier again until the battle at the Divide reached his ears. The battle between the two couriers, beneath the torn skies and the old world flag, each bearing a message for the other. And the mutant prayed the courier that had saved him had been saved in return.
Dean Domino, entertainer, singer, thief, had his last show on the Sierra Madre stage. The heist he spent over 200 years planning fell apart, just as the first, by underestimating his partner's strength. Not long after the courier left the villa, the lights in the theater shut off, one by one. Only Dean's hologram remained on the stage, singing silently to an empty room. Still, as consumed as he had been with its riches and ruin, the Sierra Madre had held him captive long ago.
Christine, her mission complete, found new purpose as the Sierra Madre's warden. She watched over it silently, by choice. Over time, the ghost people came to see her as one of the holograms. They would watch, silently, as she walked among them. At times, Christine thought of the courier, who had kept Elijah's hand from her throat. The courier reminded her of the other courier she had met in the Big Empty, and wondered if the two had found each other at last. She did not think of them again until she heard the legends of the Divide. The Divide, where the two messengers, the two couriers, fought beneath an ancient flag at the edge of the world.
You've heard of the Sierra Madre Casino. We all have. The legend, the curses. Some foolishness about it lying in the middle of a city of dead. A city of ghosts, buried beneath a blood-red cloud. A bright, shining monument luring treasure hunters to their doom. An illusion that you can begin again. Change your fortunes. Finding it, though, that's not the hard part. It's letting go.
Wait a moment. Before you go, we hope you've enjoyed your stay. Farewells can be a time of sadness. Letting go, difficult. As a guest of the Sierra Madre, you know that truth more than anyone. Frederick Sinclair believed one's life could be made anew every day. That fortunes were more than the wealth in your hands. Love. Life. Family. Those to care for, and those who will care for you. To those who know these joys, the Sierra Madre holds little they don't already have. Out in the world, beyond these walls, that is your chance to begin again. I hope you'll return in happier times. Until then, the Sierra Madre and I will hold you in our hearts. Wait a moment before you go. We hope you've enjoyed your stay. Farewells can be a time of sadness. Letting go, difficult. As a guest of the Sierra Madre, you know that truth more than anyone. Frederick Sinclair believed one's life could be made anew every day. That fortunes were more than the wealth in your hands.